wonderfully created the dignity of human nature, and still more wonderfully restored it, grant, we pray, that we may share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. How beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of him who brings glad tidings, announcing peace, bearing good news, announcing salvation, and saying to Zion, your God is king. Hark, your centennials raise a cry, together they shout for joy, for they see directly before their eyes the Lord restoring Zion. Break out together in song, O ruins of Jerusalem. For the Lord comforts his people, he redeems Jerusalem. The Lord has feared his holy arm in the sight of all the nations. All the ends of the earth will behold the salvation of our God. The word of the Lord.
Majesty on high, as far superior to the angels.
as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. For to which of the angels did God ever say, "You are my son, this day I have begotten you"? Or again, "I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me"? And again, when he leads the firstborn into the world, he says, "Let all the angels of God worship him." The word of the Lord.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
Do you know the history of Santa Claus? It goes back to St. Nicholas, who was the Bishop of Merida, that's now modern-day Turkey, in about the 4th century. During the Council of Nicaea, he vehemently opposed Arianism, a heresy that denied the divinity of Christ. Legend has it he was so passionate about his opposition that he punched the heresy's founder, Arius, in the face during the council. However, he is more famous for his love of children and giving them gifts. After his death, the legend of his gift-giving grew. St. Nicholas transformed into a legendary character called Santa Claus, which is, Claus is the Nordic name for Nicholas. As a child, I loved Christmas and looked forward to it every year. Going into Boston to see Santa, the lights, the presents, and years setting up the household manger and putting the baby Jesus in the manger on Christmas Day. As I got older, I became more of a Thanksgiving man. The stress of choosing thoughtful presents was not there, and we still got to enjoy time with family. Plus, the days were longer, more sunlight, and better weather. But I was missing the meaning of Christmas. Also, the shortest day of the year, winter solstice, was this past Tuesday. The darkest day of the year is now behind us, and every day we will see more and more light. This past weekend, I had the opportunity of baptizing two children. It is such a joy to bring new members into our faith that they can share in God's love for us. During the baptism, each of the children are presented with a baptismal candle. The baptismal candle is lit from the Easter candle, which stands near the altar at Easter, and it's a sign of the risen Christ. The candle represents the risen Christ, who is the light of the world. Jesus is the light that guides every baptized person. It also represents the flame of faith, which is to be kept burning brightly in the child's life. During the baptism, the presider says, "Receive the light of Christ." The Easter candle is also present at Catholic funerals, where it symbolizes that even in death, the body and light of Christ continues to burn in the soul of the departed. Today's gospel also talks about light when it says, "What came through him," by him meaning God the Father, "was life. And this life was the light of the human race." Who is the light of the human race? It is Jesus Christ, who is the light of the world. He reveals God the Father to us and offers us the gift of eternal life. The opposite of light, of course, is darkness. When John's gospel mentions darkness, it is referring to evil that encourages us to sin. There is a lot of evil in the world, but this gospel gives us hope by telling us that the light shines in darkness and that the darkness has not overcome it. Jesus took on human form to save us from evil and to lead us to eternal life. We just need to go to the light, follow Jesus, and bring that light of salvation to others. The darkness will never overcome the light. Today's gospel tells us the true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. Today is the day we celebrate the moment when Jesus came into this world. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. Today, as you process up to receive communion, know that God loves you. Try to meditate on how God has been there for you in times of darkness. Be grateful for the light he has shown upon you. Take that light and share it with those you love, so that they too may be saved. Finally, let me close with the last line of the book A Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens. A Merry Christmas to all of us. God bless us.
Let's stand and pray. Why are we here? Because we believe in one God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, the for all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, God from true God, begotten and not made, God is substantial of God. Through him all things were made. For us people and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to touch the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Loving God, you embrace us with light that we might no longer walk in darkness. You fill our heart with grace that we might be fervent in faith. And so we pray.
For all believers, reflecting the light of God's glory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who do justice, working for peace in a violent world, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are estranged from family, the church, or society, finding reconciliation, profound healing, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace beyond understanding, bringing our hope to those who sorrow, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who celebrate Christmas mystery in this place, inspiring one another to be a more courageous witness to Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions presented online today, especially those held in the silence of our hearts, that the Lord hear them, heal them, and continue to bless us, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And for the special intention for which this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord. Loving God, thank you for the gift of prayer, for the gift of being able to practice our faith. We give you thanks through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our offertory song this morning is number 102 in your regular hymnal, and that is Go Tell It on the Mountain, number 102.
Oh,
Make acceptable, O Lord, our oblation on this solemn day when you manifested the reconciliation that makes us wholly pleasing in your sight and inaugurated for us the fullness of divine worship through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift
up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord who is our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through him the holy exchange that restores our life has shone forth today in splendor, when our frailty is assumed by your word, and not only does human mortality receive unending honor, but by this wondrous union we too are made eternal. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the whole world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis and all of the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Richard and Saint Nicholas and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
this time next year, we'll be gone out of our lives. But we need to do the best we can to prevent it from affecting as many people as they say it's going to. Perhaps we can be part of a break to the movement forward. Our grand annual collection last week was $90,051, I think. In that 1 week, we've made our goal toward $110,000. We have reached $105,530. So thank you so much for your efforts. I'm really sick of it. You're probably really sick of me making that announcement. I'm really sick of it too. Well, this week is the end of it. You'll hear a report next week, and then you won't hear again from me about that. Thank God. And I'm sure we'll make 110. You're always people who come through with the signature parish. And I want to thank the decorating committee for going all out this year. We had some people said, you don't want to put all that stuff up, do you, for Christmas? It's going to be small crowds and it's limited. And then I said, we're going full boat. So I thank them for all of the efforts. And it's a lot of work to take down all the Advent and put up all the Christmas decorations, climbing ladders, putting up banners, making the garden so beautiful. But thank you for your efforts and participation. And for those who contributed to the flower garden, so thankful for that always. It's so beautiful. We had this book put away for last Christmas and then last Easter, neither of which we were able to celebrate publicly. And so we have a book for you down there. Please take one. It's Matthew Kelly's I Heard God Laugh, and it's a great and easy read. It gives you a whole new perspective on how to live life in a joyful way. So they're on the table on the way out. Please take one for yourself, take one for your neighbor, take one for another family member until they're gone, and there are only a few left, so we want to get rid of them this morning. So please make sure you take them until they're gone. And read them. They're really good to open our hearts in easy ways to God's message of love. On behalf of the whole staff of St. Richard, we are most grateful for your continued prayerful presence and support in all ways. And we wish you and your loved ones the very best of Christmas, the spiritual Christmas, the depth and breadth of joy and hope and love. Certainly, as the days go on and families are somewhat separated with all of this craziness of COVID in many different ways, let God be the healing grace. Let's pray. Oh, and we thank Tammy for getting here to record this morning and broadcast our and Mary, so grateful. We're so grateful for you doing week after week after week. So let's pray. Grant, O merciful God, that just as the Savior of the world was born this day, is the author of divine generation for us, so he may be the giver of even immortality for all of us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you abundantly, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I want to thank the music people for getting here, slipping and sliding. Michael is our keyboardist last day with us. Thank you very much. And always our trumpeter. You are. Thank you. So we have a message.
Thank you.
Drive carefully going home, please.
Communion will be distributed from the front of the church as you leave Mass. Please exit row by row or starting from the front. Proceed down the side aisles and up through the back of the church. Parishioners may well decide not to receive Holy Communion if they feel the risk is too high, and that decision will be honored and respected. Father Bruce, Deacon Stephen, and Josephine will wear masks. Thank you, and Merry Christmas.
Thank you, and there is only one collection on Christmas Day, and that whole collection goes to the care of the Clergy Trust Fund to support us, priests through the Archdiocese in our health care and retirement. There's one basket in the entryway, exit way of the door of the church, so please be as generous as you can, and thank you in advance. God bless you all.
Our closing song this morning is number 8 in your Breaking Bread hymn.